And today I'll talk about my thesis topic, which is called the multi-generative adversarial network. And actually it's a continual work of my previous term. And let's go for this. This is the logistic of today's presentation. And firstly, I will give a very brief introduction about what am I doing for this thesis. And I will have some review on what is my previous work last term, and then go to discuss one of the very important work, which is called the WGAN, and then talk about what we have done, and this is called the NGAN. And I will also discuss some future work that we can extend for this work. And actually, this is a very fundamental question in computer vision, is that how to generate some real images. Actually, there are many answers to this question, and recently, I think the most popular way to do real image generation is called the Generative Adversarial Network, this is the GAN, and I will first go through what is the idea behind of GAN. And actually, for GAN, as you can see in the name, adversarial network, and it's basically about two-pair and minimax gain. And the objective function is given by this. And here, D is the discriminator and G is the generator. Generator will take a noise input and generate a real image. And discriminator will map the image into a probability between 0 and 1, and to tell whether the image is belongs to the real data. And by doing this, actually, the generator will generate some fake image to fool the discriminator and tell that the image is real. And the discriminator will take some real data input as well as the fake data and try to distinguish whether an image is fake or not. And by doing, when they play this game continuously, and it's what proven theoretical that the Nash equilibrium is the generator will fully recover the distribution of real images, and the discriminator have only one half of the chance of correctly identify whether the image is real or not. And this is good in the sense that it's easily to be modeled by some convolution network, so that the training do not require any Markov chain or some probability inference problems. But there are some limitations about this method. First, it's hard to coordinate the discriminator and the generator during training, since it's easy to imagine that if the discriminator learns much faster than the generator, the discriminator will have very high confidence of rejecting the sample from the to telling the sample is fake. And if this is the case, it's very hard for generator to learn. So we need to find some way to coordinate the discriminator and generator. Another problem is called the mode collapse problem. This is a kind of overfit problem for generative network. Is that the generator will try to create image with very similar feature. For example, if we are generating some face images, the generator will keep on giving a particular face to the discriminator, even though it may look very real, but it's not the face we want. We want the generator to generate a very diverse facial feature. And this is called the mode collapse. And the third one is the generator, we can, for the original work, the generator generate image randomly, and we cannot control the attribute of the generated image. For example, if we want to train a generator to generate some faces, and we cannot control that to tell the generator to generate some male face or female face. And then I will talk about what I have done previously. And for last year, basically, I have to use a variant of GAN, which is called the DC GAN, the deep convolute GAN, and try to reproduce this result in different data set to test whether it really worked. And after doing some kind of testing, I have moved on to study the noise dimension. And you can see in this noise, the Z is drawn from some intrinsic dimension. And I have tried to study what is the effect of tuning this dimension of the intrinsic noise. And it turns out that there is no significant difference given that when there is enough dimension for noise. And very extreme case is that if I only give one dimension for the input noise, that we can only generate image with very low diversity. But if, as long as the noise dimension is large enough, we cannot see very difference in visual quality for the generated image. And I also propose an interpolation method for the random vector in order to visualize the change in the images in the learned feature space. And the most important part of last year's work, which is leading to the work of this term, is the proposed an extension multi-generative adversarial network, which consists of multiple generator and one discriminator. And basically, my work is trying to build on top of this. And firstly, I have to go for one very important related work, which I used to improve my previous work. This is called the WJN, and it has so promising improvement in the generating better image, as well as to increase the training stability, and it also prevent mode collapse. And basically, the idea is quite simple, is to change the loss function. If you have remember the original loss function is very similar. It is the original loss function, and we can see a log term here, a log term here. It seems that we just remove the log term. But what is the meaning of this objective? Indeed, it is a dual representation of the first Russian time distance, which is also known as Earth Moved Distance. And this term, the later part of this objective, which maximized by D. Actually, this is very intuitive that if the generator, if we have a good measurement of the Russian time distance, and as long as the generator can reduce the Russian time distance between the first distribution and the real distribution, we can recover the image quite well. Another point to note that is that the D must be restricted to be K Nefschitz function. Yes, otherwise this equation is not work. And actually I will further explain what is W distance. And this is actually a distance measurement between two probability distributions in a special space. And rhetorically, it's also the optimum cost to move one distribution to another. Actually, for example, in this figure, this is a one-dimension image space that is considered only one pixel. And here is the probability distribution for this asset. And here if we have two delta functions here, it means that there is a pixel, for example, a pixel of having particular value, another pixel for having another value. And what is the W distance between them is actually the L1 norm of this separation. If you want to move this delta distribution to this one, we have to move all the mass way to this red one. And here we see that this W distance is very large. And for this kind of distribution, the purple and the green, the W distance is quite small because if we want to move one distribution to another, the only part we need to move is only this part. We only need to move this part to this region and we are done. So the W distance of this kind of pair is much lower. And might we need to use double distance? And what's the advantage of using double distance is that it has very well behaved gradient in terms of the learning. And also, it's intuitive that it prevents more collapse. Here we have an example here. And for green one is the real distribution, which is a uniform distribution in this region. And for the generated the free distribution, is this kind of delta function here. Actually, the generator has suffered from severe mode collapse. It's only remembered three kinds of pixel. And but here, if we use the traditional discriminator and generator approach, as long as the generated sample falls within this real region, it's very hard for the discriminator to tell that this sample is not good enough. It's actually real. But if we want to see, if we look at the W distance, it's obvious that the W distance is non-zero. And there must be much better way for the generator to recover the reduce the W distance. And then I want to talk to the main part of my work, which called the MGAN in the full length is the multi-generative adversarial network, basically to involve multiple generator. And what is the motivation behind is that actually for real life images, we assume that they are in multi-nodal nature. For example, for a face image, we have some mole which is a male and another mole which is female. And also for animal, we have different kinds of animal. For example, dog, cat, or cow, or other kind of animals. And it was found that in the WGAN, it failed to converge in some of these multi-class cases. And one of the intuitive ways to solve this problem is to using multiple generator to generate different mode of the real distribution. But a very natural question to ask is that if we have multiple generator, how should they coordinate with each other? And the proposed method involves a two extra module, which is called the mixer and the separator. And what is the function of mixer? Actually, it's responsible to mix the fit distribution induced by different generator. And here, what is the meaning of mix is that we are considering using a mixer have different kind of, have chain different generator, and the mixer can select one of the generator to generate sample at a time. By doing so, we are effectively mixing the fake distribution. And if we have a well-defined distribution for all generated data, and we can define a W distance between the mixed distribution and the original data distribution. And here we want the mixer to be work with the generator. That is, he wants to help the generator to minimize the distance. And in general, mixer can depend on the noise input. But here, if you want to have a good distance estimate, indeed we can only need to know about the probability of using each individual generator. And this is given by this objective. So if we have this setting, we don't need to learn a very complicated function for the mixer. We just need to learn a simply a probability vector for the mixer to know how to mix the first sample. And intuitively, what is the optimum value for mixer? For example, if my data have two Gaussian probe, and one is for male and one is for female, and it may be a case that my data set have more males than female. For example, the chance of having a male is 70% and the 30% is female. Then the mixer's suppose one generator learned about males and another generator learned about females, and the mixer should tune the probability of choosing male generator should be 70%, and the probability of choosing the female generator should be 30% in order to match the whole fake distribution to the real distribution. But there is some problem in this equation. Since in this equation, we does not afford the trivial solution that every generator will recover the real distribution. And here, if we have having every generator recovering the real distribution, we are actually wasting a lot of computation resources to doing the same thing as one single generator. And so that we propose a W-distance-based regularization in order to make the generated sample to be different. And here is the another objective for the separator and the generator. And here is actually the W-distance between the fake distribution to other fake distribution. And the generator, for every generator, they should try to maximize this distance in order to cover a different kind of feature. And here we have to put another, which is a separation constant, in order to balance the separating force and the force of pulling the generator towards the real distribution. And here is the graph of the whole model. And for a single noise input, I will feed it to different generator. And after the different generator will generate a fake image. And here we have a mixer which select one of the generator from here and to give the mixed distribution to the discriminator. And the discriminator will then feed the real data part into the discriminator, and the discriminator will try to find out the W distance between the real distribution and the mixed fake distribution. And I call this the pooling gradient. It will help to pull every fake distribution towards the real distribution. And another part is the pushing gradient, which is produced by the separator. Here we feed all the generator into the mixer, and a separator will help us to calculate the distance between distribution of a single generator and the mixture of other generator. And the pushing gradient will help us to push every generator apart. And here is the main chain link order of different kind of module. And I have divided the training into two phases. And the first phase is the pure pooling phase. Since initially the generator will generate very noisy images, and it is very hard to tell the separator to separate the noises. So that in pure pooling phases, we don't include any pushing force and we do not change the separator. We only have an ordinary single generator approach that change a discriminator, then change the generator alternatively in order to try to make the fake images to look more like the real images. And then when the generator have produced reasonably good fake images, we start to give a strong pushing force in order to separate the fake images. And here is the training order. We start first change the discriminator, then we have to change the mixer to adjust the probability of using different generator. Then we have to change the discriminator and the separator again, and then finally change the generator. And since it's obvious that the pushing force will push the generator to in order to maximize the distance between every phase distribution, the fusion force actually will decrease the image quality of each generator. So we have a we propose that we should decay the pushing gradient throughout the training. That's why we have a strong pushing phase and a weak pushing phase. And for the experiment part, and for this work, we basically work on some synthetic 2D data. The advantage is that we can easily visualize the evolution of fake distribution throughout the training. And let's see some example. Before we go through the example, here is the basic setup for the neural network for the generator, discriminator, and separator. And actually, it's very simple MLP with two hidden layers with 16 neurons. And S will share part of the layer with the discriminator. And here we can see this GIF image. And from this figure, we can see that the green dot is the real data. And the blue, purple, and red dot is the fake sample from different generator. And throughout the training, they will start to learn where to recover. They are actually recovering a separate mode of the real distribution, as you can see here. And here, I have also test about the force sensitivity. What I mean by force sensitivity is that the separation constant lambda. If I set the lambda to be very large, actually in this case, they will push all the generator away and the real distribution cannot pull the fake distribution to the designated notation of location. And here, when I set the pushing force to be very low, and it's shown that the generator will converge quite slowly, but it will also do the work of separating different modes in the real distribution. And here I have also proposed an heuristic way to make the training more smooth is to introduce a hyperparameter called the push period. That is to not pushing in every iteration. It's alternatively push and pull, so that it will stabilize the overall performance of the theorem. And here I have tried to use this for a lower noise dimension. Here you can see that the shape of the distribution is quite different because I use only one dimension noise. Seeing the noise dimension is one and the MLP is quite a simple function, and so that it's hard for the MLP to learn a non-linear distribution. It also likes a line here, but it can also separate, the generator will also cover different modes of the real distribution, even if we use a very low dimension noise. And here I also saw some sample in other hard shape. I call it hard because, as you can see, maybe the color is not quite clear, and it's the purple color and this is the blue color. And you can see that there is some overlapping part here. And it seems that it's quite hard for the separator to learn two moon shapes. Both of them learn a half Gaussian block like that. And if I use another lower dimension noise and same thing happens, it just can't learn the moon shape goodly. And even increasing number of generators may not help. Actually, the reason behind is that for each generator, they don't have the notion of, they don't know what which portion of the real distribution they are responsible for covering. They just try their best to move closer to the real distribution so that it cannot control some generator to try to cover part of the distribution here, which if ideally we want to make this part to be covered by this generator, but this generator try to get some of the portion here, so to make the overall performance not that good. And here we can show that actually mixer play an important role in if the Gaussian bulb here have different density. Here with mixer, actually the top two bulb have lower density than the lower one. And with mixer, it can learn very well. But with that mixer, obviously the generator will try to cover part of the distribution here and this either. And this causes some kind of overlapping of the image feature. And then how to evaluate the performance of the firmware? Actually, if we use the W distance approach, it's very intuitive because W distance itself, which the loss of the generator, is already a very good measurement of the performance of the generator. If we see that the W distance between the real distribution and the fake distribution is low, it means that the generator is learning well. And lastly, we'll talk about some future work. And actually, the most obvious future work is to employ this model into generating real images. Seeing in this thesis, I only test the model with the synthetic low dimension data. And actually, it shows some potential in dealing with real images. And another important work is to maybe test other regularization method for the separator. Here we are learning for each generator, we need to learn a corresponding separator in order to separate the generator, which computationally heavy indeed. So there may exist other method for us to separate the generator instead of training so many separator. And another thing we can try is to share feature among the generator. Why is this important is that considering for real images, for example for face image, we believe that the different type of face, for example male face and female faces, may share some of the common feature. And by the means of sharing the feature map among G, we can save time to learning those similar features. And last but not least, we can of course try other loss function instead of the current W distance based discriminator. And I think this the end of our presentation. Yes.
Any examples to show?
Actually, I have a bonus example is for image data, real image data, but actually it's not included in the thesis. See, for the thesis part, I only do experiment on the synthetic data like this.
Okay.
But I have actually try to continue the work and try to make a real image data example. And here, these two are from two separate generator.
This is generated?
Yes, and this is for the same input noise. You can see that one generator and second generator will have generate a quite kind of similar face but very opposite feature. For example, you can see a kind of black skin color and very bright skin color is from two different generator.
Okay, so could you go to page 16?
this one.
Yeah, this one. So as this is shows the working flow, right? There are some generators. So how they are mixed? So there are multiple generators. How they are mixed?
Actually, by mixed here, I mean to select a generator. Since here, I will give a batch of noise here, and the mixer will try to select the portion, different portion of generator, and mix it to one single batch.
How they are selection?
Actually, it's not actually selecting. It's just a random bean of different batch of generator. Because here we can see that what we need to know for the mixer is only a probability of selecting a particular generator.
Okay.
So that is effectively a random mean of this quantity. And here I can produce the this quantity here, and here I can have learned a mixer here. Actually, it's a probability vector to or a random mean the rate of different generator.
Okay.
And after multiplying it, it will produce a single value, and I can feed it to the discriminator and learn the mixed distribution, the distance between real distribution and mixed distribution.
So what's the granularity of the generator? It's a pixel level or a block with multiple pixels? So
it's a whole images.
Whole images?
Yes.
So but whole images, but I know, so it's iterative. I mean, so for example, you will start at the corner or corner pixel and to go through, or you have a matrix, you just do some multiplication and the matrix will,
yes,
all the values will get.
Yes, actually, here for real data, we have to carefully design the network for the generator. Actually, the one of the state-of-the-art design, actually using the BCGAN generator, and actually is many convolution is a convolution network.
Okay.
And for an input noise, it will start to do the convolution to make it larger and larger. This is the inverse, not the inverse, is the bedrock of convolution, the transport convolution, to make a input noise to a larger feature map, and then a larger feature map, and finally to become a real images.
Okay, so also a question about the W distance.
Yes.
W distance is measured the distance between two distributions.
Yes.
But I mean, the distribution of the whole generated image, right? So probably there is a discriminator, they have some distribution, and there's a generative, there's some distribution, you won't measure the distance. But the distribution does not specify the exact, color of each pixels. In the worst case, I can get a totally random noise images, but the distribution may have the very short distance.
Actually, by here, the W distance for images, here I mean that, actually, this is oversimplified example for that, this is only 1D images. Actually, for images, there is a very high dimensional space.
Okay.
And it's the, for a high dimensional space, and every image is,
I can understand. The high dimension means it actually has a lot of constraints and information, so it's not that it's, say, one way.
Yeah.
Okay, I understand. Okay. I have no more questions, so you can follow.
Okay. So please turn to page 14.
14.
I just want to clarify, what do you mean by mixer here?
Okay. Mixer is here, actually the formulation generally is to given a set of, for example, the mixer has to choose one of them.
So he choose one of them or do a certain kind of combination of all the samples or just choose one?
just choose one of them. But in terms of the expectation value, actually we don't need to really design a network to choose one of the generated images. We don't need to know about the probability for the method to select the image.
So basically, you produce a probability, right?
Yes, a probability vector of selection.
So what's the input to the method?
Method is basically, there is no input for the method.
So in any cases, if the method say they have two generated A and B, let's say, and the method produce say 40% for A to generate,
yes,
and 30% for B to generate,
yes,
in under all the cases, it does the same probability.
Yes.
So no matter what kind of sensitivity.
Yes. If actually we can give some prior information for the method to learn, for this particular noise, I will choose a particular generator, but I want to make the whole framework to be simpler and does not require any kind of supervised data. Which
so basically, just apply it to bring together several distributions.
Yes, yes.
And also, when you try to, so basically M is basically just a prior distribution on finite space.
Yes, yes.
Okay. And then for such a distribution, there's some constraint. For example, all the probability values should be positive, and also there's some to one.
Yes.
And how do you enforce this constraint in your optimization?
Actually, I actually updated this N by the gradient by minimizing this function, and I have do some kind of hack here is to whenever it's 4 to 0, I will make it to 1. I'll make it 4 lower than 0, I'll make it back to 0, and if some of them is larger than 1, I will make it back to.
But here, what you want to enforce is that all the values sum to 1.
Yes, actually, what I do is that, for example, for if I have three generator, for a method, I only learn two variables.
Mm-hmm.
And the last one is 1 minus the previous two.
Okay.
And how to ensure that every generate, every probability to be larger than 0, I just simply do some hack here is do the crimping. Just if I have negative probability, I will make it back to 0. And we normalize the whole vector. But actually, I think when I do the experiment, it's seldom to occur that case.
That's because you only work with this simple case, just like those three cluster two-dimensional examples. But in the real world case, it's impossible.
I have run some real example, but it doesn't happen, fortunately.
How many generators do you have?
I have tried 10 generators.
Okay, then probably not that a critical issue, but at least you should actually take this into account,
mm-hmm,
and when you present this idea. And also in page 15. So here you use an lambda to balance the separation and the other objective that you want to achieve.
Mm-hmm.
How do you choose this coefficient?
Actually, just do experiment and try, which is good. But intuitively, this should be much smaller than 1. That's because the pushing force doesn't help us to make the generator to look more like the real distribution. It's only make the generator to separate the distribution.
So that's a very small positive value.
Yes, it will eventually, in this example, I have used a very small positive value, and it turns out that it can separate them.
But this example is this example is a very simple case. Because in these cases, you have three well-disjoint clusters.
Mm-hmm.
So even that you give a very small push force to push those diffusions away, it can converge to those, because in the middle, there's an empty space.
Yes.
You want to converge to the empty space. But in your case, the diffusion is not that simple. It can be composed of multiple clusters that overlap with each other. In those cases, the dynamic behavior of your algorithm may not be that simple.
Actually, in this, I have proposed an other kind of separator when I do the real data distribution. This is the very first method I have tried, and I actually find that it's not working quite well in real data. And I have another separator, which is using kind of like a classifier, approaches the cross entropy, but it's whole another story and should not be included in this business report. Yes.
And in page 17. So here, you in your strong position phase, you turn distance in four stages, and I'm just wondering why don't you turn M and D together in a single step jointly? You separate the turning of M and the turning of D into two separating steps.
Actually,
if you just turn M plus D plus S in a single step?
Because after changing the M, the D is no longer representing the distance. The distance have to maximize over all M and G, so that whenever I move the M, I have to change D again to make sure that this is really the W distance.
Okay.
This is the reason. But actually, I have in the original implementation, I have tried to just D plus M plus S, and then change G, it will also give the same effect. Since the error is very small here. But I think to be more precise, I have to, after changing the M, I have to change D again to make sure that D is actually giving the true W distance.
In page 22. So here, I noticed that in these simple cases, you assume there's three generators, right?
Yes.
And actually, the underlying data distribution actually contains exactly three clusters. But in general or in practice, the number of clusters or the number of modes in the underlying distribution is unknown.
Mm.
So it's seldom you can assume exactly the right number of clusters.
Mm.
So what would happen if the number of generators does not match the number of underlying clusters?
It's a good question, and I did it so, and it's down here. I have tried to have one single book of Gaussian and having three generators. And if I tune the pushing force to be small enough, it will also completely fill up the full Gaussian ball. And I didn't show that particular example here.
But,
but then
based on this answer, it assumes that the pushing force, okay, the is controlled by certain coefficient, okay,
yes,
depends on the actual structure of your underlying distribution.
Yeah.
If you know that it's a single cluster and know that you have a free generator, then you can tune that pushing force.
Yes.
But in practice, you know nothing about the underlying distribution. Then in those cases, how would you set the pushing force?
Actually, it's a very good question, and for the first time I do dealing with the real image data, I have test one value and see the output result, and it turns out that if too small, there is no significant difference. If too large, it makes the image very noisy, and turns out I don't use this kind of separator, I use another kind of separator for real image data. And here for the last image, I am using another separator approach, which is using a cross entropy separator. But again, it's another story.
Okay, then I suggest that last time you present this story, that you should actually mention those kind of issues in your presentation.
But I think, for my thesis only, I only do this kind of synthetic data and didn't include any result of real image data. So to make this a official presentation for my thesis, I just include this part.
That's
and
all
then,
my questions.
Okay.
Professor Law, yeah.
Yes.
Hi, Kevin.
Okay. I think the two professors asked very valid and good questions, and we should keep them into your to-do list. Okay. I just want to comment a little bit on Tim's work. He actually done a lot of experiments on real data, and we managed to get some interesting results. It's not conclusive. Yeah. So as I said, we propose a new, a different way of doing separation, and then we couldn't make a conclusive observation that separator is not really useful. So we are going to do more experiments on this view, on this regard. So that's why he only included the synthetic experiments into the thesis. Yeah. So